Fort Ticonderoga, the New York landmark that played such a big role in the Revolutionary War, is getting ready to celebrate the 250th anniversary of the founding of the United States. The Mars Education Center at Fort Ticonderoga unveiled a new exhibition called A Revolutionary Anthology, Power of Place. It features more than 100 artifacts, with many of them on public display for the very first time. It also shows the geographic impact of the American Revolution, including displays of battles that happened both here and elsewhere. The fort says it's an important way for people to honor just how far this country has come.
These anniversaries are moments where we can reflect on our own past, the past of our nation. And what I think is important in this regard is to acknowledge that our country has been around for 250 years.
The destination plans four more exhibitions as part of the 250th celebration. As for this year, Fort Ticonderoga has special programming from July 4th through July 7th. One of those events is on the evening of the 4th, called Ticonderoga Guns by Night. The 4th of July is also a really big deal in the hometown of the only U.S. president born on the holiday. Of course, it's Vermont's own Calvin Coolidge. The village of Plymouth Notch will celebrate the 152nd birthday of the 30th president on July 4th. Events include a reading of the Declaration of Independence, birthday cupcakes, an address from an actor portraying the president, and the Coolidge Cup National Speech and Debate Tournament from the Coolidge Foundation. There's also a really special offering this year about the First Lady, Grace Coolidge.
We have an author interview that'll be occurring at 10 a.m. in the Union Christian Church. That's going to be with Diana Carlin. She's the author of Remembering the First Ladies. And we'll be joined by Jennifer Coolidge Harville, who is the great-granddaughter of President Coolidge. And we're going to be discussing the legacy of Grace Coolidge, what she meant in the 1920s to the American people, and what she means to the American people today.
We obviously today think it's cool that President Coolidge was born on the 4th of July. Have you ever come across anything that he might have remarked on about the coolness of having that as a birthday?
Not that I've read. Oral tradition, and I can't say one way or not whether it's true, but oral tradition says that as a little guy, President Coolidge thought that the July 4th celebrations were for him until he reached about the age of 4 or 5 and realized that maybe he shared his birthday with America.
As you saw in that video from a previous year's observance, the tradition includes a wreath laying at Coolidge's grave, led by the Vermont National Guard. Thanks so much for being with us this morning, and happy 4th of July from all of us at NBC5. Have a great week.